Welcome to Gainesville, Florida, as ABC Sports presents CFA football, a Southeastern Conference matchup. The Tigers of Auburn are here to take on the Gators of Florida. Hi, everybody. I'm Steve Zabriskie, and welcome to one of the South's oldest rivalries. This is the 69th meeting between Auburn and Florida. But in the 11 previous years that Pat Dye has been the Auburn head coach, Florida is the only school against which he has a losing record. He is 5-6 coming into today. To make it even worse, not only is Florida Field a tough place for all visiting teams to play, but since Steve Spurrier took over as the head coach of the Gators about 2.5 years ago, the Gators are a perfect 14-0, unbeaten here at Florida Field. We'll be back with more, but now it's time for our regular feature on what's new in the world of sports science and technology, as well as a word from our ABC stations. Welcome back to Florida Field. I am joined now by legendary former Michigan coach Bo Schembechler. And around football, there's a saying that quite often teams reflect the personalities of their coaches. Coach, I think that was quite true of some of your Michigan teams, reflecting your personality. But today we've got a couple of coaches with different personalities that I think do reflect in their teams.
Well, in Pat Dye at Auburn, he's coming into Gainesville with a strong defensive football team. You got to understand that this is a Bear Bryant protege. He thinks defense, deny the run, run the football yourself, be more physical than the opponent, put extreme pressure on the passer, and you're going to win the game. On the other side of the coin, you have Steve Spurrier, an ex-quarterback. He's going to move his receivers around, change the formations, play a chess game with the Auburn defense, and try to pick them apart. It is a contrasting style without any question. But the key to the game will be how well the Florida offensive line can control that Auburn defense. They're going to start two freshman offensive tackles. Steve, I don't even like to think about starting one freshman offensive tackle. But Reggie Green will start at left tackle for Florida, Jason Odom at right tackle, and they're going to try to protect Shane Matthews as he throws the football against an Auburn defense that has already registered 21 sacks this season.
Well, we talked about the series record and how Auburn has dominated over the years. Florida's catching up, and look at that. In the last 9 games here, Auburn just 1-8. Last year, of course, Florida winning big at Auburn. We'll be back with the kickoff. Harrison Houston is going to run it out from about 2 yards deep. Good hole. Harrison Houston with a big start for the Gators as he brings it out to the 38. Shane Matthews, a senior now. He's from Pascagoula, Mississippi. On the first play, Matthews to throw, and he completes it. Willie Jackson with a big first down into Auburn territory. Inside the 40, stopped by the middle linebacker, James Willis.
In Auburn territory.
They're at the 42. It's a 22-yard gain, and Matthews to throw again. And again, he hits Willie Jackson. Inside the 30, dropped by Calvin Jackson, number 8. Now it'll be a field goal attempt by Bart Edmiston, who has only made 2 of 6 this year. It'll be a 38-yard attempt. And it is good. And Shane Edge, averaging 40.5 per punt, who kicked it away from about his own 5. To the 50 and dropped there. A punt of 41 yards right at the average of Shane Edge. Kevin Carter on the stop for Florida. We'll be back. Auburn trailing by three, first and 10 from midfield. Bostic getting outside, first down. And Larry Kennedy saves a touchdown.
Steve, that was an unbalanced line. They keep an end over on the short side and put the fullback in motion.
So Scott Etheridge will come on to kick. Clay Helton, number nine, a backup quarterback, is the holder. This will be a 22-yard attempt for Etheridge. He has made 11 of 14 this year. And it is good. 5:42 to go in the first. A drive by each, a field goal by each. We're tied at three. Kennedy, Brian Karkuska. Again, we'll kick it off for Auburn. Houston from the two. Another good hole. And he gets away. Finally run out of bounds at the 37 by Brian Robinson.
Gave it to him in a power sweep.
Correct is a junior out of Pembroke Pines, Florida. Faking the reverse, Rhett keeps it. First down, down to the Auburn 42. Otis Mounds, the free safety, making the stop.
Steve, that's an unbalanced line for Florida.
Eric Rhett with a 15-yard run and a little help from his friends. It's another Florida first down. Jack Jackson in motion. Matthews to Willie Jackson. Gets a block. Just inside the 30 before he is thrown back. Third down and really closer to four than five. Matthews with good protection again, and he completes it to Rhett out of the backfield. Eric Rhett stopped by Carrick and Cunningham, but not before Florida has another first down. So far, those are Matthews' numbers, 5 of 7 for 60 yards, so he's had success early. Second and 10 from the 13. In Houston. And that's one reason they added that great big gator head in the locker room. And it has been difficult for visiting teams. Nobody's been able to beat Florida since Spurrier's been the coach here. Matthews, as we start the second quarter, completes it to Rhett. And James Willis may have saved a touchdown.
Hurt his ankle again, and he had to leave the game after Florida gets the first down.
Keidra Malone in at tailback. Kelvin Randolph at fullback. Fake to Malone. Matthews dumps it out to Malone. Malone into Auburn territory at the 38. Another first down. Mike Pina on the stop, and here the 11:45 to go in the second quarter. Second down, five, Florida. They're at the Auburn 20. Touchdown! Willie Jackson! Penn State battling Boston College, retaking the lead. Auburn trying to mount a drive and get in it. They're down by 14. Second and 10. Play action. Completing it to the tight end, Derek Dorn. And Dorn well down the sidelines to about the 42. Now it is third down and 7 at the 39 of Florida. Stan White is just 3 of 10 passing. Complete to the tight end, Andy Fuller. And Fuller is rammed out of bounds. But Second down, 9. They have a balanced line now with 2 tight ends in the game. White on a naked bootleg. Carter's after him. Finally hauled down by Henry McMillan. Well, now we're back again at the 26 for a 36-yard field goal attempt. Etheridge has been out there for 15 minutes. And this time he hits it right through there. Scott Etheridge got another chance and made the most of it. 2:14 to go in the first half. It's now Florida 17, Auburn 6.
It's been a punter's quarter. There's no question about that.
And slowly, Auburn has been gaining some field position with the good punting and the penalty. Daniels with a couple of 53-yarders in this quarter. A low line drive.
That is a bad one.
And it goes out of bounds. Thomas Bailey couldn't catch it, but because it went out of bounds, it didn't make any difference. It'll be at the 39 of Auburn, and they gain a great deal on that exchange. They'll have it first and 10 with 3:56 remaining in the third.
Go for it on fourth down.
Right now it's second down and 7. Fake reverse to Parker. Orlando Parker spinning and getting out of bounds, and a flag after the play. Ben Hanks, number 11, over there on the sideline. Orlando Parker made a couple of guys miss him, but then took a shot. And Scott Etheridge is on. The hold will be at the 35. It'll be a 45-yard attempt. He has made a 49-yarder this year. Officially now they say 44 yards. And it is good. Etheridge with a lot of leg. His third field goal of the afternoon. And Auburn at least gets some points out of the drive. As with 1:06 remaining in the third quarter, it's now Florida 17 and Auburn 9. But Florida's done a pretty good job of obtaining it. Today they've run 23 rushing plays and had 26 pass plays. And for the year, the difference is only 4 plays different. Tony Davis in. Completing it to Jack Jackson. Jackson short of a first down as he's thrown down at about the 29. Yeah,
he gave that play directly to Matthew.
He doesn't stay right around the 50. Play action. Matthew flips it out to Bilkey. Bilkey close to a first down, but hammered by Chris Schelling and Fred Smith, and then Otis Mounds came up. They really need to make almost 14 to get the first down. Matthews over the middle, Tony Davis. First down at the Auburn 37. Well, Auburn's number one defender, James Willis, number 51, is out of there right now with a broken nose. They've lost their middle linebacker. It is third and 15, Florida. Again over the middle, this time it's complete to Hill. Aubrey Hill with a first down. Chris Schelling the tackle. And for the second time, third and long, Florida comes up with it. The report that he has broken his nose.
Well,
he's now back in the game.
Linebacker with a broken nose will play. If you were a wide receiver or something else, he wouldn't play.
Or a kicker.
But linebackers play.
Second down, 6. Again, Tony Davis cutting it back nicely and getting to the 10. Another first down. Auburn took him, and since he went to Auburn, 5 other players have gone to Auburn from Dillard High School in Fort Lauderdale.
He's also a very fine safety man and an excellent tackler.
Matthews throwing back, wide open, but short of the touchdown, but fumbled out of bounds.
They're going to say that he retained possession and was down. George rushing, held short of a touchdown, fumbled the football. But since his forward progress was stopped, they rule that it will be Florida's ball at the 1 yard line. And that's another reason why Tony Davis is in there at tailback, a freshman, along with Kedra Malone, number 32, a sophomore who started the game. Touchdown, Florida. Shane Matthews scores and culminates a 78-yard drive. And the Gator chomp. I'll tell you what, Florida's doing it against what was ranked as a pretty good defense. Auburn came into this game ranked fourth in the nation. They've given up only 229 yards a game, and Florida has 334 yards of offense so far. White on first down. Over the middle and completing it to the tight end, Derek Dorn. A reminder, coming up next here on ABC, more regional college football action. Two key conference showdowns, number 4, Alabama, number 13, Tennessee. Most of you will see that game. Some of you will see number 3, Michigan and Indiana. That's next here on ABC. Going without the huddle. Breaking through is Tony Richardson as he has the first down out to the 45. White again, no huddle in the shotgun. Silent count. Looking for somebody, flips it out of the backfield to Alex Smith. And Smith runs out of bounds, bumped out by Del Spear, but well into Florida territory inside the 30. White now 14 of 30 for 122 yards. Third down. Flips it out, Alex Smith. And not much doing. He'll be well short of the first down. Tackled by Monty Grove. The Florida defense this year had been giving up over 25 points per game. They've only given up 9 so far this afternoon. Fourth down and 6. Stan White with time.
Oh,
just short of the first down. Thomas Bailey standing short of the marker.
Here it is. He's over there yelling for the ball, and as he does, he steps forward of the marker and steps out a half a yard short of the first down. Had he kept his composure a little bit, stayed in bounds and dived for it, he'd have gotten it.
Stan White can't believe it. He nailed the pass right to the numbers of Thomas Bailey. Matthews just running the clock out again.
28 there, didn't know where to line up. He went in the backfield. They had 5 men in the backfield.
I don't see a flag.
Well, he came up on the line then. Made it an unbalanced line.
Well, they're going to let the clock run out now. Yeah. There are less than 10 seconds remaining. Shane Matthews showing flashes of his great ability. And Steve Spurrier still unbeaten at Florida Field. Now 15-0. For Pat Dye at Auburn, Florida remains the only school Pat Dye does not have a winning record against in the SEC. He falls to 5-7 in his 12 years as head coach of Auburn against the University of Florida. And when they say the crowd's a factor, Bo, I think they mean it.
Well, I think it is here. And this was a fine football game. If you take the flags out of there, the numerous flags, it was a well-played game by both sides. There weren't a lot of turnovers. And Florida deserved to win the game.
We'll be back with a final word from Gainesville and Florida Field, where the Gators have taken care of the Tigers.